Yeah, I'm wondering what its ability to go over limbs is.
Right, yeah, it looks like it will go over things like crouching medium kick.
Yeah.
You know, I really like the mid-range footsies game in this game so far because it doesn't seem like any of the characters that are in this build just rely on one-button footsies. I feel like everybody has to use a couple of different options, keep it interesting, keep it complex.
We saw a couple of people earlier with Cammy using Crouch Fierce, and that thing reached really far. And I haven't seen any of the Cammies use Stand Fierce. I mean, Stand Forward or Stand Short. Two very good pokes.
You found Stand Short last night, and you were harassing with that.
Yeah, uh-huh. Because it recovers really well, so it's just like short, 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 short.
Yeah, you can walk at somebody pressing shorts, making them block it.
Now, like we said, the light attacks, unfortunately, don't cause that chip damage, but it's just good for pressure. Oh, yeah, big punish.
Huh?
Oh, okay. It's okay. Oh no, thought he was getting the hit off that low forward. Oh, that was sick.
Meterless too.
Oh no, maybe thought it was gonna cross up. Here we go. Yep, see how that goes right through there. You really have to be ready to punish that with something super fast. I don't know if Chun-Li has anything fast enough to punish that reaches that far.
I don't know, Frame did it yet. And whatever it is now, it probably won't be like that when the game ultimately comes out.
So. Wait, you can't watch it and just read the Frame Day?
Sorry, man.
Oh, here we go. EX Lightning Kicks. Oh, yeah. Punish time. That's so cool. All right. Yeah, you see how that EX Dive Kick? So in Street Fighter 4, a lot of times people would try to use that jump EX Dive Kick to get in, but it was always too far and they would just land and whiff and waste meter. Not in this game. She goes so far with that move, yeah. In fact, I kept going over people's heads with it because I kept thinking it was the old distance.
That's true, you did.
Oh, great throw. Here we go.
Wow, the chase down.
Beautiful uppercut there from PR Rog. And he's going to take it for Team EG1. Team EG1 now 2-1. Team EG2, unfortunately, going to finish 0-3. So now we're ending the day at Mad Catz versus Team Razor. Team Razor is up right now 2-0. Team Mad Catz is 1-1, I believe. And so if they win this, there's going to be three teams at 2-1. We have to have quite a tiebreaker. I believe so, right? Is my math wrong here? I need to bust out the abacus here.
Sure. Yeah, man, we'll go with it.
All right, sounds good.
I'll check the notes that I've been writing down scrupulously this entire time.
I was confident in my numbers until everyone kept looking at me like, wait, are you sure? And I was like, what? Shout outs to our staff here. I'm gonna send the ever so resourceful Mr. Hanzo Gonzo to go check the scores here.
Yep, we'll let you know. We'll find out shortly. In the meantime, Team Mad Catz and Team Razor.
Well, we saw what RB did with Birdie ahead of time earlier.
Wow! That was some good stuff. That has a great hitbox on it.
Yeah. You can see Cammy's jump roundhouse not nearly the beast that it was in Street Fighter 4.
Right.
But she more than makes up with her ground moves, I feel like, are much better than they were in Street Fighter 4. And they were pretty good in Street Fighter 4.
Oh, yeah. I really like her footsie game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. It's something that I really look forward to using a lot, her footsie game. Oh, wow. Punished it with the low jab. So that might be all he can get at that range. It's just a low jab. And as a Cammy player, you'll take that for the random chance. Oh!
Oh!
And gets the combo off of it.
All right, here comes Cammy, though. She can pressure.
Yeah, she's also...
No!
Oh, okay. Yeah. And yeah, if you guys do notice, whatever side you lose on, or win on is the side that you start the next round on. So you could be starting on the left side as first player, but then if you lose on the second side, next round, that's where you start.
I love his use of that stand strong button.
So good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because at most ranges.
Oh!
Oh, yeah, onto the banana peel. Yeah.
That banana!
So like I said, the key for Cammy to get through the banana is to actually use her V skill to hop over the banana.
All about fighting over that banana right now. I think that additional space control is very interesting.
Yeah, it's a very appealing move. All right. God, I swear the banana lasts forever, too.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I love that dashboard into it.
Trying to come in. You see that Birdie has full meter.
Yep, that one hit and that stand strong, that's all he's fishing
for. That's all he wants.
Oh, a little too far.
Oh,
he just raw!
What a confirm.
Raw headbutt right into super. Just do it.
So it was on a game-by-game basis? Is that what she means? Okay, so how many... It's not whether your whole team wins, it's whether how many... Games you had as an individual player across the teams. That's super complicated. in my explanation, it's super complicated. But you get the point. It's about how many games your team wins, not how many entire sets your team wins.
Yeah, so basically by taking this, by taking that last match, mathematically, Team Razor has won.
Shout outs to Team Razor. Shout outs to Birdie.
But you know what? They don't know that. So they're well, maybe they do now.
They do. It's too late. Yeah, now they do.
Never mind.
Now it's time to jerk around.
Oh, got over the banana. Oh, nothing else after that. You can combo that into the headbutt. Yep, oh, just like that. Is. Oh, that jump attack button is so good. That jump forward, right?
Yeah, jump forward is amazing.
So good. Oh, because okay, just goes up there for a two-hit combo. Wake up command throw. RB is really making this character work so well for him.
It's a good character, that's for sure.
Oh no! As we mentioned, there's a little bit of that delay. Yep. And so there it is, right there. RB's gonna take that first round. As you mentioned, he was a Hugo player before. So, yeah. I think he might have found his character. Oh, there's the jumping fish. Oh, and then gets the jumping grab.
Yeah, there are those weirdos who like big body characters a lot. And this is, I think, a really, really good example of that. He has the command grab mix-ups that you want. He has the range that you want. He has mobility. He has space control.
Yeah, he's pretty much not what you would have expected out of a grappler because his buttons are so good. And really, honestly, the soda can from across the screen acts like a projectile.
Yeah.
It forces the opponent to want to do something. And even if you don't throw the soda can, like you said, you just eat donuts all day. Oh, but here we go. Tokido gonna spend all the meter. Take that round. But that's a nice thing. I mean, one of the things that we definitely did not see a lot of in Street Fighter 4 was supers, because FADCs and EX moves are so valuable. But in this game, meter is... It comes by so easily. So we're definitely going to see a lot more supers, lot more variety usage of that meter.
Right.
RB trying to bulldog his way through with just that stand strong headbutt.
Both fishing around with the chain.
Activates his V trigger, makes his headbutt a little bit
nice
safer.
Punish.
Not safe enough, yeah.
Oh,
smart stuff. There you go. And Tokido is going to take it over RB. It's like the first person we've seen all day to defeat him. So here
takes
comes
a birdie
Shen
to beat a birdie.
All right, so...
So who's up next now?
Xian is coming up.
Xian is down there,
The
yeah.
only player that we saw use Nash earlier.
Right, we and actually, had a very interesting take on Nash.
Yeah. Now, we've seen a representation of all six characters then, didn't we? Yeah, we did.
I guess you're right.
Yeah, okay, that's awesome.
That I'm is really, really
glad.
Cool.
I'm really glad.
And nobody, like, made these players play the characters that they're
yeah,
picking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's just
yeah.
who they wanted to pick, so I'm really happy that they did pick different characters.
Between 12 and there's six characters, there's a high probability of it, so.
Again, this very projectile-based Nash. We did see a couple of anti-airs out of Xian. We saw Crouching Fierce and we saw EX, I don't know, Jaguar Kick, I don't know.
We saw the armor on that Towards Fierce again from Birdie. So he has armored moves, great buttons, moves that go under fireballs.
You know, we haven't seen it, but down toward Fierce is a way to get under fireballs. He does a little slide.
Yeah, much like a belly flop.
It's like Chun crouching strong, actually.
It looks like he's going for a slip and slide, basically.
Right. Down toward Fierce.
You see it, like, grab Nash out of an EX move, it looked like, oh!
Wow!
Wow! Oh, just keeps the pressure going.
Might have tried to jump out there, I don't know.
Yeah, Xian hasn't been able to get any momentum. You see the fireball game not really working too great right now. But yeah, you kind of want to go in a little bit with Nash as well. He's got a really good... Oh, did he just try to super through it? But one, no Sonic Boom at all. And two, that was really far. Oh, got through there. All right, so he's in now. Oh, he's going to use the bananas.
Oh, nice. He uses banana so much and not can.
Yeah, that's true. Well, can is a little bit more startup and delay, I think. Good block. Oh, got right through there. And then a command throw. So here comes Tokido. All the pressure in the corner.
Oh, early.
And he just uses that opportunity to get out of there. Uses the V trigger to combo into his EX. Great combo. Good damage. And he's going to take that round. Which of these two teams will go up 2-1 here in this match?
Oh, yeah, I like the idea. That is how you get through fireballs, but just a little too far.
Yes. Oh, you see the startup on that Sonic Boom. Like I said, very, very slow.
You're right.
Yep, see,
there's
not
the problem.
Especially against a Birdie jump forward kick. That button is so good.
I think that was Roundhouse.
Oh, did he use Roundhouse that time? Okay.
But it seems like all of Birdie's jump attacks are good.
Ooh, didn't quite make it over. It's that little delay at the startup that kind of throws it off. Like against Ryu, that timing would have worked. But because it started a little bit later. Oh!
Ooh, he went for that. Not a grab, by the way. It's a hit. Oh, yeah, did he get there?
Oh, he did! And he's gonna combo!
Nice reaction.
Oh, it's not quite dead. Wow! If that was just raw, it probably would have killed, maybe. The Sonic Boom might have scaled it a little bit.
He has an overhead, yep.
Oh, he went for it. Yeah, the chain.
Oh, Tokido knew it. He was standing up anyway.
Oh, here comes Tokido. He's got a full meter. He just wants that! That's all he wanted! That's all he wanted! Is this gonna be enough to kill? Not quite, but he's right there. Oh, V trigger into the sky to avoid.
Wow.
The command throw and come down and get the hit. A neutral jump might not have been fast enough. Who knows? But the V trigger definitely was. Great stuff from Xian. Again, when you use Nash's V trigger, he has three areas that he can go.
Right.
Now, I know he can go forward. He can go up. I don't remember where the last direction is. Maybe in place or something like that. So I definitely use mostly the forward one.
Yeah, that's what I've seen mostly too, but I like that creative use of it.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's
really
very
cool.
Interesting. It's great to see somebody approach a character like this that, even though he's technically returning, is very different than before. Approach it and just make up something new.
Look, one of the things that a lot of people don't give Xian credit for is the creativity that he has. He is one of the smartest players out there. He's one of those scientists who really does a lot of studying. In fact, you know, we all know him as one of the best Gen players, if not the greatest Gen player in the game, right? he made up like almost all of those strategies. He came up with almost all of the standard Gen stuff.
Wow.
Wow, Daigo just gets it dizzy. Oh, the damage. Yeah, nothing.
By the way, he went for chip there and it actually wouldn't have killed.
That's right. You could have just blocked.
But there was no block, so it killed.
Yeah. Ooh, auto-corrected uppercut from Daigo Umehara. And then goes right, that's projectile.
Oh,
he went for
a
parry.
But you see him try to do stuff after that.
Right, you have to parry, parry. Oh, low forward super. Not quite enough to kill, but very hard road here. Oh, he gets through there. Oh, just a little too far for that combo to fully connect.
He's got to get that V trigger back. I don't know if he's going to get a chance.
Oh, here we go.
We see the parry coming in.
Yeah.
But I think we also see one of the downsides of parry, which is that it doesn't have that many active frames.
Mm-hmm. Oh, he tried to catch it with his V skill and just mistimed it. Daigo takes it over Xian. And now we're down to the last player on both teams. Earlier we saw Tokido's birdie wreaking a little bit of havoc, but here comes Arby going with birdie against Daigo. Daigo's Ryu. Hope everybody at home has been enjoying this round robin event between these three extremely strong teams. Team of players. Hope everyone here at E3 has been enjoying this treat as well. Here we go.
I love seeing Daigo's take on this character.
Yeah.
I think it just really plays into what he has historically done with Ryu.
Yeah, once Daigo gets comfortable with his character, I think the offense that he's going to be able to put on with his character is going to be ridiculous.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. A little late on that jump there.
Yeah, that is one of the problems that Birdie has. Mm-hmm. He has a pretty floaty jump. Good buttons out of it, but he's just up in the air for so long.
Okay. Knew that low forward fireball wouldn't combo at that range, so just did low.
Oh! There's the crush
trigger.
Counter.
Yeah, the crush counter. Oh, there's that stand roundhouse. That really nice looking stand roundhouse.
Good job to not stick out a button in the air. That dragon punch would have worked otherwise. Now we have the corner.
Command throw. What's the next mix up? Command throw again? Daigo read it. Jumped away. Here we go. Activates V trigger. Ah, so Daigo does the same. The fireball game a little bit trickier. Yeah, you see right there, you tried to get over it with the command throw, but that fireball is too fast. Oh, nice! Just using the armor on Towards Fierce. Tried to do it again, but here we go. In the corner, what's the mix-up? Really didn't want to go in there for much.
You know, we haven't seen it, but Birdie does have an overhead in Toward Runoff.
Yes, that's right. Oh! Okay. Combo into super! Is it enough? It is! Daigo now at match point. Just enough to kill.
Oh no.
Yeah, a little too far, but just a command throw from Birdie. Oh, another one.
Oh, getting a little too cute.
Try to catch him with the Towards Fierce, but a little bit too far.
Ooh. Counter again.
Yeah. Something that the players here probably aren't too familiar with.
Right, yeah. First time you see it, it's hard to know what to do.
Yep.
By the way, this round so far has been immaculate.
Oh yeah, RB has been playing this super strong. He's working on a perfect. Okay. Oh!
Thought that was going to be it. Not quite.
Yeah. Oh, that should do it. Perfect on Daigo Umehara, RB of Team Razor. Trying to keep his team undefeated here. They want to be the definitive winner, regardless of how you want to pick the winner. Oh, and he gets right through there.
Yeah, nice reaction.
Ooh, I almost thought that combo.
Still harassing.
There's the banana.
I feel like Ryu doesn't really want to approach anyway, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, great.
This jump
read
timing
again.
Has been excellent.
Yeah, RB has read those jumps, those fireballs perfectly. Oh! Wake up, command throw.
One more mix up. Where's that run? Who wanted the overhead?
He wanted the overhead. Oh, that low jab, so good. Oh, and then a wake up low jab to take it. Team Razor remains undefeated, 3-0 here in this team tournament. Congratulations, Team Razor, Fudo, RB, and Xian. Traveling all the way out here from all parts of the world.
Yeah.
Taiwan, Singapore, and Japan.
They really deserved it. I'm very impressed by how quickly they picked up some characters that they've never seen before. You know, Birdie as a returning character is so, so different that it's hard to say that he even is the same character.
Right.
So when you pick him up, which was 4 hours ago, you know, you have a lot of work to do. You have a lot of work to do. And it looks like they all, a couple of guys already did that.
Yeah.
Already happened.
Another thing that I was really glad about is that out of all of the players in this tournament, the one player people probably were least familiar with was RB. But we got to see, you know, the kind of skills, the kind of reads that he had there. Mm. I mean, doesn't matter what Street Fighter game you play, jumping over a Daigo fireball is not easy to do.
Yes,
and he did it at least two or three times successfully.
Yeah.
So good stuff to RB.
Yeah, absolutely right. But I do really like Daigo on Ryu. I think it makes a lot of sense with this game's Ryu. I think that's really cool. We were talking with Combo Fiend yesterday, and he says that he's very excited to see what Daigo does with Ryu. Very excited to see what players like Alex Valle do with Ryu, because it's sort of that old school Ryu style with a lot of all around stuff, but very dangerous in addition to that.
Right, right. You know, I mean, I'm excited right now because, I mean, what we just saw right there, really cool tournament. There's only six characters. We've got a lot more characters to come, and you can already see where a lot of the matchups are going to go and everything like that. So I'm actually really excited just to see, as the more characters get revealed, you know, how the gameplay is going to expand.
Yeah.
Because, I don't know, it just seems really interesting to me right now. And not only that, like, you can see that a lot of the characters are coming in here very different than their previous incarnations, right? So even if you know a character, like let's just say like, oh, Zangief's in the game. Dude, we have no idea what he's going to do. We have no idea what a V-skill or a V-trigger would do with that character, or Blanca, or even like an El Fuerte or something like that.
Could be totally different.
Yeah.
In fact, I hope that the rest of the cast is as unique as these characters are so far, because that really has been happening. You know, these characters are very interesting, very unique.
Sorry.
Very cool.
We see PR Rog out the window right over here. He's mimicking Birdie. He's just eating food and throwing banana peels and rolling soda cans on the floor.
Yeah, well, soda cans are pretty good. So are bananas.
Uh-huh. Exactly.
Pretty strong in a street fight.
You know, I drink a lot of soda, so now I know I can actually fight pretty well. You know, just drink the soda, roll.
Maybe you should
roll
carry around a giant novelty-sized donut, too.
Yeah,
see how
exactly,
that works out.
Exactly. You know, get one of those, like, those swimming pool floaty things, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, man. No, I hope everybody enjoyed that, not only here at E3, and thanks for everyone who is here at the Capcom booth checking out the game, but I hope everybody at home enjoyed it.